Hi, third grade. Today, we are going to start our new anthology text. The title is Martina the Beautiful Cockroach, a Cuban Folktale. This story is retold by Carmen Agra-Didi, and it's illustrated by Michael Austin. The genre of this text is folktale. We even see in the title that it is called a Cuban folktale. That means that this is a folktale from Cuba. Folktales are stories based on the beliefs and traditions of a group of people or region, and it's passed down from generation to generation. Folktales often have themes like helping others, and they teach a moral or a lesson. These stories usually have animal characters that act like humans. Let's listen to the summary in both English and Spanish to learn more about this folktale.
Martina, the Beautiful Cockroach. A folktale is a story that is passed on through the years. This is a folktale from Cuba. Martina is a beautiful cockroach who lives with her family in a street lamp. She is 21 days old, and it is time for her to marry. Martina needs help to choose a good husband. Her grandmother gives her some surprising advice to help her decide. Martina's grandmother tells her to spill coffee on the shoes of each suitor. This is a trick to find out what the suitor is really like. Martina is surprised to find out that the coffee test works. First, a rooster comes and asks Martina to marry him. He seems nice, but he becomes angry and yells at Martina when she spills coffee on his good shoes. The same thing happens with a pig and a lizard. Martina is about to give up when a small brown mouse catches her eye. Unlike Martina's other suitors, the mouse is gentle and kind.
Martina, the Beautiful Cockroach. Un cuento tradicional es un cuento transmitido a través de los años. Este es un cuento tradicional cubano. Martina es una hermosa cucaracha que vive con su familia en un farol de la calle. Tiene 21 días y le ha llegado la hora de casarse. Martina necesita ayuda para escoger un buen esposo. Su abuela le da algunos consejos sorprendentes para ayudarla a decidir. Le dice que derrame café en los zapatos de cada pretendiente. Es un truco para saber cómo es el pretendiente en realidad. Martina se sorprende al ver que la prueba del café funciona. Primero, viene un gallo y le pide a Martina que se case con él. El gallo parece bueno, pero se enoja y grita cuando Martina vuelca el café en sus finos zapatos. Lo mismo pasa con un cerdo y un lagarto. Martina está a punto de darse por vencida cuando ve un pequeño ratón color café. A diferencia de los otros pretendientes, el ratoncito es bueno y amable.
From the summary, I learned that our main character is Martina. She's 21 days old, which is an adult for a cockroach. This story is about how she finds a husband. Let's take a look at the essential question. What makes different animals unique? Read about Martina. Find out how she chooses among her unique admirers. Let's start reading this folktale and see what happens with Martina in her search for a husband.
Martina Josefina Catalina Cucaracha was a beautiful cockroach. She lived in a cozy street lamp in Old Havana with her big, lovable family. Now that Martina was 21 days old, she was ready to give her leg in marriage. The Cucaracha household was crawling with excitement. Every señora in the family had something to offer.
I really like how the author chose to use the phrase to give her leg in marriage. Normally, the phrase is to give your hand in marriage. But since Martina is a cockroach and doesn't have hands, they changed the word to give their leg in marriage. The author also chose to use this word crawling because cockroaches crawl. I think that's really clever when an author plays on words to fit the story, or the characters in this case.
Tia Cuca gave her una piñata, a seashell comb. Mama gave her una mantilla, a lace shawl. But abuela, her Cuban grandmother, gave her un consejo increíble, some shocking advice.
Who is the main character in this story? The main character is Martina the cockroach. What is the setting? On the previous page, it said that Martina lived in Old Havana, so the setting is Old Havana. What is the main plot of the story? The main plot is that Martina is ready to get married and she's trying to pick a husband. Folktales often present a problem and then use the solution to teach a lesson. The problem in this story is that Martina is ready to get married and she wants to find a husband. Martina got 3 gifts. How is Abuela's gift different from her mother's gift and her aunt's gift? Well, they give her things and Abuela gives her advice. Tia, her aunt, gave her a seashell comb. Her mother gave her a lace shawl. And Abuela gave her advice. Which of those gifts do you think will be the most valuable to Martina? The most valuable gift will be the advice. Sure, the objects are pretty, but the advice will help Martina to make a smart choice.
You want me to do what? Martina was aghast. You are a beautiful cockroach, said Abuela. Finding husbands to choose from will be easy. Picking the right one could be tricky. But, stammered Martina. How will spilling coffee on a suitor's shoes help me find a good husband? Her grandmother smiled. It will make him angry. Then you'll know how he will speak to you when he loses his temper. Trust me, Martina, the coffee test never fails.
The text uses this word, suitor. It says, how will spilling coffee on a suitor's shoes help me find a good husband? What do you think the word suitor means? The word suitor means a possible husband. What is the shocking advice that Abuela gives Martina? She tells her to spill coffee on her suitor's shoes to help her pick a good husband. But how will this help Martina solve the problem of picking a husband? Well, spilling coffee will allow her to see how he talks to her when he loses his temper, which will help her decide if he will be a good husband. Martina doesn't want to end up with somebody who's going to have a bad temper and react poorly when they get angry. So by spilling the coffee on his shoes, she can find out right away what his behavior is going to be like when he is mad. Let's continue reading.
Martina wasn't so sure. Meanwhile, Papa sent El Perico, the parrot, to spread the word. Soon, all Havana, from the busy sidewalks of El Prado to El Moro Castle, was abuzz with the news. Martina, the beautiful cockroach, was ready to choose a husband.
When it says all Havana and names specific places, it helps me to visualize the bird flying around a city, calling out, telling people his news. And I know that when people are abuzz, they are all talking about something. So that helps me to visualize or picture in my mind that many people are talking about Martina. Whoa, look at this fancy guy. Let's see what the story has to say about this character.
As was the custom, Martina would greet her suitors from the balcony under her family's many watchful eyes. Daintily, she sat down and crossed her legs. And crossed her legs, and crossed her legs. She didn't have long to wait. Don Gallo, the rooster, strutted up first. Martina tried not to stare at his splendid shoes. Keeping one eye on his reflection, Don Gallo greeted her with a sweeping bow. Caramba! You really are a beautiful cockroach. I will look even more fabulous with you on my wing. With that, he leaned forward and crooned. Martina Josefina Catalina Cucaracha, beautiful muchacha, won't you be my wife? Martina hesitated only for an instant. Coffee, senor?
Uh-oh. The coffee's coming. She's getting ready to spill it on his shoes. How do you think that Don Gallo, this fancy rooster, is going to react when he gets this coffee spilled on his shoes? Do you think he'll pass the coffee test? In these illustrations, I can see that Don Gallo has a lot of jewelry on his feather fingers and a bracelet and these sunglasses and what looks like a suit jacket and shiny shoes. Based on this illustration and the text, I can infer that Don Gallo is very fancy, and he's also kind of full of himself. It doesn't seem like he cares much about Martina, seeing as he's leaning on her and kind of smushing her down a bit. As I read, I can use the text to help me visualize what is happening in the story. The text describes so much more than what is in the illustration. For example, in this paragraph, it says that he strutted up first. When somebody struts, it's kind of like they're walking while showing themselves off. It's like they're walking with swag. Even though these illustrations are amazing and have tons of detail that we can learn from, pictures aren't moving and we can't see how he is strutting up to Martina. We have to visualize that by reading the words. Let's turn the page and read on to see how he does with this coffee test.
Right on cue, Abuela appeared. With a quick glance at her grandmother, Martina nervously splattered coffee onto the rooster's spotless shoes. "Oh my," she said with mock dismay, "I'm all feelers today." "Kiki-riki!" The rooster was furious. "Clumsy cockroach, I will teach you better manners when you are my wife." Martina was stunned. The coffee test had worked. "A most humble offer, senor," she said coolly, "but I cannot accept. You are much too cocky for me."
How does Don Gallo react to the coffee test? He gets furious and he tells Martina that she is clumsy. How did Abuela's actions contribute to the sequence of events? Abuela's actions contribute to the sequence of events because she's the one that brings the coffee to spill on Don Gallo's shoes. Who are the characters in this section? The characters in this section are Martina, Abuela, and Don Gallo. I don't think there was even a chance that Don Gallo could have passed this test. He appears to act haughty and proud. Don Gallo was too proud of himself and his appearance. It says that he kept one eye on his reflection as he spoke to her. He couldn't even give her his full attention because he was too busy looking at himself. And before he even asked her to marry him, he said her beauty would make him look better. Good thing she had that coffee test. All right, boys and girls, that's where we're going to pause the story for today. We will start back up tomorrow with the second half of the story and see what other suitors ask her for her hand in marriage, or should I say, her leg in marriage. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.